Sudanese women played a prominent role organizing the protests that ousted former President Omar al-Bashir in 2019, after 30 years in power. Since then, women are playing a prominent role in the transitional government. A woman has been appointed a Chief Justice, the first, not only in Sudan, but in the entire Arab world. An unprecedented four women were appointed to cabinet positions in the new government, including the country's first female Minister of Foreign Affairs, Asma Muhammad Abdullah. But women are still marching to amend the laws and restore the rights taken from them under the strict Islamic code enforced by Bashir's government. The Sudanese Professionals Association, or SPA, was one of the key groups behind the protests that led to Bashir's ouster. Samahir al-Mubarak, who heads the SPA's Pharmacist Association, remains active in politics.
I've never felt that we've reached a level where we should stop. So the motivation that powered people to overthrow the Bashir regime is the same motivation that is pushing people to continue to reach the revolution's goals of freedom, peace, and justice.
The June 3, 2019 crackdown on pro-democracy protesters in Khartoum left more than 120 people dead, including the eldest son of Amir Qaboos. His death didn't deter Qaboos from being involved, and she's now the deputy chief of an organization of people who lost relatives in the uprising.
What we are doing is the continuance of the martyrs' role and their sacrifices. We didn't reach our goals yet. We didn't see the freedom, peace, and justice the martyrs demanded. We will continue until we achieve all of the revolution's goals that our children sacrificed for, and to restore the rights, till we see Sudan the way our children dreamt about and we all are dreaming about.
Qaboos and al-Mubarak were recently awarded the 2020 Freedom House Award for their role in advancing democratic change in Sudan. The award was under the theme of the power of protest. Naba Muhiddin for VUA News, Khartoum.